Good morning from Scotland. I'm on a bit of a nature walk again. Beautiful morning here, no rain. The sun was shining, but it's quite cloudy. Anyway, I'm heading down to some lagoons, and apparently there's a lot of wildlife down there, including deer. So hopefully we can see something. I've just been talking to a guy who was checking these gas boreholes for methane gas, checking the level, because this area here, back in the old days, just behind me, they used to dump a load of rubbish, and it was known as the tip, for obvious reasons. So it's now sort of been covered with earth and landfill. So what they've done is they've got all these different gas boreholes so they can check the methane levels. So this is the gas borehole. It's basically a point where they can check for the methane levels in the gas. So this walk that I'm doing today is the National Cycle Route 75 of Scotland, and apparently it goes all the way from Edinburgh through to Gourock, through in Glasgow. I'm not sure how, because I can think of where it breaks on the west side, but maybe there's a few breaks in between and then it continues. It's a really nice walk, as you can see. You know, you're surrounded by woodland and wildlife, different plants. So I think we're just approaching the lagoon now. But the guy I was talking to, who works for the company that measures the level of methane gas, he said that the lagoons here were quite overgrown, so I'm not too sure how much we'll be able to see, but fingers crossed. There you go. There isn't much to see after all. Not in this particular one anyway. This is another one, so you can see here they've got this fence. And then there's another barbed wire fence behind it. I suppose if you came down here and sat for long enough, you might see some nice wildlife. So they've actually put a fence up here. You can see that behind me, which means you can't get close to the lagoon. I think there's three of them here. Like something out of Braveheart. I expect someone to come rushing at me with an axe or a big sword. Look at these growing on the tree. I think you'd have to go a lot deeper in here if you wanted to see deer, and then you'd probably have to sit for a while. So I'm afraid there hasn't been much wildlife. But one thing I wanted to talk about since I've been back in Scotland is these wind turbines. Now, and I think it was my last video, I mentioned that there was a lot of them on the horizon, and most of them were not actually doing anything. I was through in Glasgow just yesterday, was it yesterday, I think? And on the way back, I noticed there's a lot of wind turbines on one side of the M8 motorway. And again, not moving, not turning. You know, it makes you wonder how much these cost and how much wind energy they are actually producing. You know, is it just a big waste of money? And, you know, what happens when in 20 or 30 years' time they're no good? Do they take them down? Does it turn into a wind turbine cemetery? Food for thought. You know, I would imagine that unless these wind turbines are actually turning all the time, then, you know, it's maybe not worthwhile. Of course, if you look on the official websites, everything is rosy in the garden, but I don't know if that's just trying to be, economical with the truth. The other thing that's actually relevant is these wind turbines, how do they affect nature and wildlife? And actually, people that are living in the area, if you read some of the information on the internet, it says that the wildlife can be affected. I'm not too sure how. I'm guessing maybe just done, you know, by the construction of these things. And I mean, let's face it, they're huge. It's not like they're small. Obviously, you'll have cables to lay to reach them and maybe go between them. I don't know if they've got junction boxes somewhere. My point is, you know, if you look around, there's a lot of deforestation. I mean, look at this here. This is actually part of the nature reserve. And, you know, they're clearing this away. For what? It looks like it's probably for buildings like this. Once again, you know, deforestation. I remember when I was younger, we never saw anything like this. But it's certainly changed. The one thing I would say about this nature reserve and the psychopath and everything, when I was growing up in Scotland, we didn't really have anything like this. You know, we had to make our own fun, entertainment. We were always outside kicking a ball, or fishing, or going for walks, but there was nothing like this, where you have like a nature reserve with a proper psychopath. So, yeah, it's got its plus points. Whew. I feel tired just watching that guy. So just back on the subject of wind turbines. Now, there'll be a lot of you that disagree with me, but I've worked in the oil and gas industry pretty much all my life, and I'm aware that you cannot have, or you cannot use fossil fuels for eternity. But there's still a lot of undiscovered gas, which is kinder on the environment. You know, you're not drilling offshore. Well, in some cases you are, but a lot of it can be onshore, and it's more environmentally friendly, I believe. So I still think we need to look at different ways. Obviously, you've got hydrogen, wind power, solar energy. Although in Scotland, it's not so good. But certainly, you know, where I live in the Philippines, we've got solar panels on the roof to harness the sun. And it's brilliant. Not only does it eliminate power cuts, it reduces the electricity bill. But I like this nice little walk. And, you know, it's got a nice wee canopy here, covered by the trees, apart from all the flies that is buzzing in your ears all the time. But disappointed, I haven't seen much nature on this walk. I've probably done about, I don't know, 3 or 4 miles. We'll be right back. Scotland is coming to an end, guys. I'm heading back to the Middle East soon, and the next time you hear from me will probably be from the Middle East. I'm going to be there for maybe 2 to 3 months, and then I will be retiring to the Philippines. Could be a bit longer, not too sure, but it would definitely be this year. So I will keep you posted, and thanks for watching the videos and everyone who subscribed. Cheers for now. Bye.